Au Centre européen des consommateurs, on est compétent pour les litiges transfrontaliers. On a régulièrement des plaintes, par exemple, contre des vendeurs en France, donc notamment les ventes en ligne. Donc régulièrement, des consommateurs belges vont sur des sites étrangers, français, allemands, néerlandais, etc. Et alors, ils commandent quelque chose sur Internet et ne sont pas livrés.
That's when the European Consumer Centre can get involved. Established in Belgium in 2001, consumers call to resolve disputes with suppliers out of court. It's one of the ways the EU aims to increase consumer confidence. The EU is looking into ways to improve the system with online dispute resolutions. The rapporteur on the subject explains the internet doesn't have borders, so why should online shopping in the EU?
There should be one button on which we press and it guides us further and helps us to solve the problem. What we intend to do is to convince the sellers that they should have information on their websites in case of conflict, in case of problems, where to seek help. And this should be the information about the online dispute resolutions.
Online dispute resolution means you can make complaints from the comfort of your own home. An important step for cross-border litigation. There are 29 European consumer centres across Europe, and the moves towards alternative and online dispute resolutions is good news for the European consumer centres.
Ça va permettre de reconnaître encore plus les centres européens des consommateurs. Donc nous, on a un avis plutôt positif à ce niveau-là, une genre de reconnaissance de notre travail.
The Commission proposed the online dispute resolution in November of last year. So it's in the early stages. The vote in the Consumer Protection Committee is planned for May.